my name's Dan Tarrant, and I've been hanging out with your kids all week in the Marian room at Religious Ed, and it's just been awesome. You have awesome kids. You really do, and I know it's because you guys are awesome parents. I know no one is perfect, no kid is perfect, no parent is perfect, no family is perfect, but you guys really do have good kids, so you must be doing something right, and you must be allowing God to be a part of your family in some way. I can see it just in the way that your kids interact with God and the things we talk about with God in the Marian room. Today we talked about Emmett from the Lego movie. Emmett discovers at the end of the movie that he has a unique and special plan for him and for his life. But he also discovers that that's not just true about him, it's true about all the Legos. It's true about everybody. And isn't that exactly what God tells us in the scripture? God says he knows the plans he has for us, plans to give us hope and a future. The Bible says that God doesn't make mistakes when he creates things, that he just creates good things, and therefore you are good. And if there simply is a God and that's all you believe, then you have to believe that you are good, and then you have to believe that there is a purpose for your life because that God doesn't make mistakes. You also have to believe that the only way to have peace and joy in this life is to have a right relationship with that God, because he's where you came from, and he's where you're going. We talked with the kids about the plumb line analogy I did with you guys when we met as adults. And I showed them and I said to them that we will only have peace, we will only be centered when we're in harmony with our point of origin, which is God. We will only have peace when we're good. We'll only have peace when we focus on him and make him the center. And that's exactly what Jesus Christ said in the scriptures. He said, "Seek first the kingdom of heaven, seek God first, and everything else will come to you in due time, in the right way, in the right time. Maybe not in the way that you plan or desire, but everything that you need will come to you in time, if you have a right relationship with your God, if you can be still in his presence and know that he is God." Well, that is exactly what we do when we adore Jesus Christ in the Eucharist. Now, this is an empty monstrance, but tomorrow, Father is going to place Jesus Christ in the Eucharist in the monstrance for your kids to experience what's called Eucharistic adoration, where they can be still and know that he is God. Now, I don't know about you, but being in the front of Jesus Christ, in the presence of Jesus Christ in the Eucharist, just makes it easier for me to talk with him and to be honest with him and to be real with him, and also to be real with myself. There's simply no hiding in the presence of the Eucharist for me. I don't know if that's the way that you feel, but I know that's the way it is for me. You know, it's only in the Eucharist that the invisible God, who is everywhere, places himself visibly somewhere. And the Bible says that whatever we do to that bread and that wine, we do to the body and the blood of Jesus Christ. It's your one opportunity to experience the God who's everywhere invisibly, somewhere visibly, before you see him face to face in the next life. I pray that that part of your relationship with God grows. I pray the same is true for your kids. I pray that your relationship with Jesus Christ, the God of the universe, grows through his presence in the Eucharist. God wants to meet you there. He wants to meet you everywhere in your life. But if there's one place he desperately wants to meet you, it's where he offers himself physically in his body and his blood, given on the cross for your sins. And that's in the Eucharist. I pray that this week your kids grew in their relationship with God and their understanding of Jesus Christ in the Eucharist. Unfortunately, I won't be able to be there tomorrow with them. Instead, they're going to have a Eucharistic procession and adoration, and I'm going to be off to Steubenville, Ohio, to spend some time with our youth group as we experience the Franciscan University Youth Conference. There's going to be over 3,000 kids there adoring Jesus Christ in the Eucharist, just like your kids will be adoring Jesus Christ in the Eucharist tomorrow on Friday. Pray for me and our experience at Franciscan University, and I'll pray for you and your families and that you have a great rest of the summer and that you're blessed. Remember, in all things, God has two purposes: to draw us closer to himself and to the people around us. There is nothing that gets in the way of those purposes. Sad times, joyful times, successes, failures, even sin can somehow lead us to draw closer to God and closer to the people around us if we just choose to do that. Jesus said the great commandment is to love God with all your heart and to love your neighbor as yourself. This summer, I pray that you just pursue your relationship with God and your relationship with those that you love. And I know that if you do that, you'll be pursuing his plans. and you'll be pursuing the God who's present in the Eucharist. God bless you and enjoy your summer.